What's home, girls? I got that podcast out here, Mr. Lee.
Anti-socialite. That's one.
What's up? What's up? It's your girl, Just V.
And it's your girl, Vina.
And you already know we are the Anti-Socialites.
Yes, yes.
We back with Jazzy in the house. Woo! By accident. What's good?
I don't think it's an accident that she's dope. No, I think she's doing this shit on purpose.
It's like that.
It's so funny. it's by accident.
You sure?
On some cool shit, like, not for real.
All right.
Like, that's how I got my name, was dope by accident. Like, I got it on accident.
So, but, I mean, let's get that story. Let's talk about it.
I was in the studio. I messed up on some like melodies that I did not like. I didn't like what I did. And then the girl was like, "Yo, that shit's dope. Keep it in there." And I was like, "Nah, erase it." So she was like, "Oh, so you just dope by accident?" And I was like, "Yo, that's my fucking name."
Don't it happen like that though? Like, yeah. You least expected.
When I least expected, because I was Jazzy. That's my real name.
Yeah, I seen a picture. It had you all like dialed up.
Yeah. I tried to be dolled up and shit.
I was like, yeah, because your hair, I used to be jealous every time I seen you with your hair. I used to be like, that's some bullshit. Nah, like, I used to be so mad because her shit be late.
Nah, right. Like, what's so crazy, like I always was like, I love like doing different shit with my hair.
Okay.
And I always like was cool with that. And then my hair came out when I started, let this bitch do my hair out here. She fucked my hair up. And I was like, oh shit. And I said, well, let me just get braids, twist to like grow it back. And then I actually started falling in love with my twist.
Okay.
And I was like, oh shit.
Yeah.
All right, cool.
It's a look.
And twists work out here because the humidity and shit.
Oh my gosh.
Like,
I went somewhere. It wasn't good. I went to Haitians that did my hair. Like, it was 163rd or something like that. Killed my shit.
Yeah, she was Haitian. She would do my shit.
Yeah, so clearly we gotta stick to Dominicans.
Clearly.
I put a perm.
My friend was not cute. But nah, we
didn't even touch the hair. And texturized the shit out of my shit.
Right. But you've been out here for a minute, like, rocking the scene. I remember I first seen you at, what was that place on Washington?
Room Service.
Room Service.
I know all the clubs.
You was fucking like, the crowd didn't know what to expect. And you came out there and you was just singing. You was like vibing and like, I didn't know who you were. But I was like, And then right after that, it was like the Timbaland cosign and all that. Like, how did you input yourself into Miami? Because you're not from here.
Mm-hmm.
How did you input yourself into the scene?
It's not easy.
It's not easy. What's so crazy is like I always... I didn't see it as a big deal, but people around me be like, yo, nigga, you know, you're from Memphis, and you came here doing shit that a lot of Miami niggas ain't doing. I'm like, what? I didn't get it.
Yeah.
But it's just because it was like only one of me on the beach. Like, at the time when I was, like, this was like, I came around when I was 20.
Mm.
So this was like 5 or 6 years ago. So, like, when I came here, like, I had the Timbaland cosign, I looked like this. First folks won't let me get in the clubs, and niggas would not let me in the club. And I felt like, yo, like, why? Then I met Simply Jets. Simply Jets took me under their wings. Then Jules, when before Jules got popping, me and Jules. And then Timbaland, I kind of had the Timbaland co-sign, but they didn't really get me in the clubs. But it was Simply Jets and Jules.
Okay.
I ain't gonna front, who kind of like put me in the club scene. And then when I got in the club scene, then that was it. Like, there's nobody looks like me in the club. I'm like the only tomboy in the club. So I'm stent like, and it was kind of weird, like, yo, you know what I'm saying? But I think after that, like, I just started staying in the clubs. If I wasn't in the studio, I'd be in the clubs because I just knew, like, that these niggas know who I am.
Right.
And then I started talking to the DJs, yo, I'm so-and-so artist. But Tim never, like, Tim co-signed me one time at an event, but it was always just me going out on my own, doing my own shit. I was always, even if my niggas wouldn't go out with me, I went out by myself.
Mm.
But I made sure, like, I'm gonna go out, even if they go into the club, so you don't wanna know who I am. And that's what, and shit really worked.
Yeah.
That shit really worked.
That's dope.
I mean, cause I bet you had the vision, like, I gotta touch the people.
I gotta touch the people.
If he not co-signed it, like, a co-sign doesn't always mean I'm gonna walk you everywhere you go.
And just mean that I'm gonna push you, cause you still gotta put in the work.
Facts.
I feel like you get more respect when you don't put the work in.
Facts. Like, that's how I always been. Like, I feel like me being an Aquarius, I'm really big on being on my own shit. Like, I don't like to ask people. Yeah, I don't like to ask people for shit.
So, tell us how, like, How did you get from Memphis to Miami? Like, what was the turning point? What made you decide to come here, of all places?
Well, Wisdom, my brother, one of the dopest producers ever, he was under Timbaland. He was Timbaland's, like, protege. And, so, like, he's from Memphis, but he moved to VA. And he's older than me, so he knew about me in the city.
Okay.
So, like, he was in his own book about me. He was following my Facebook. Then he hit me up, like, yo, oh, you a songwriter? And I was like, yeah. And he was like, well, I'm seeing some beats. I couldn't write to none of them because it had that Timbaland sound. It was kind of weird. It was a weird sound, so I couldn't write to it.
Okay.
But I don't know what made him flop me down. I never wrote to one of his songs. But it was something he believed in me to the point where he was like, yo, Jazzy, I'm desperate. I need a writer. I'm going to fly you down for a week. They flew me down, and I met Tim, and then Missy was at the studio, and I was telling people to let me meet Missy, and I was only supposed to be there for a week, then we went to VA, whose team was working on Missy's project, and then I got to meet Missy, and then I ended up staying for like 6 years.
Really?
So then I stayed with Missy for like 2 weeks at her crib in Atlanta, and that's when I learned, oh my gosh. That was amazing.
Oh my god! I don't know. I was like, I've met Missy too. I don't know. I really got excited. Like, I was there, but
it was retarded. I'm really a student of this shit. Like, I feel so old, but it's really nice.
But she's like,
yo, I feel like I feel like because all this shit, like, I was really a student. Like, I really sat with Timbaland, didn't get no money. I sat around Missy, like. Broke, but she took care of us. Like, she fucked with me, you know what I'm saying, at the time. But yeah, like, I was really a student, bro.
What was something that she, like, said that she'll never forget?
I'll never forget. So, I'll never forget this, dog. I'm gonna tell this story forever. we was in Atlanta. We was staying with Missy for like a month. Nigga, when I'm talking about, we didn't go out. We worked every day. My brother Wiz snuck out the house, went to a strip club. I was so mad, I did not snitch on him. I was like, bitch, you going out without me, nigga, and I'm in this house. You know, even though the house had everything we wanted, I don't wanna go out. It's Atlanta.
It's Atlanta, like.
It's Atlanta, right? Atlanta, for me, is like playground.
Right.
So, like, I text her. Cause my homies was having a party. I was like, yo, I'm gonna text Missy, see if I can go out. She's upstairs, I ain't going up there, I'm gonna text her. So I was like, Missy, can I go out, you know, for a minute? She said,
hell no.
Yo, it took 30 minutes for her to text me. She said, come upstairs to the studio. Oh. So I go upstairs, man, on a big ass TV. She got a network. It says, she's like, you see this? She was like, it was like 220 million. She says 220 million. And they missing some millions. Like, they missing some. She was like, damn. She was like, she was like, I worked so hard for this. She was like, and if you don't, like, she's like, I know you nowhere near that right now. She's like, you can get there, but this is where you start. She's like, I don't go out. I don't do this. I don't do that. And, like, she made me feel, like, so bad. Like, I understood what she was saying. Like, right. And then the next day, she like, let us all go out. We all went out. She took us out. But, like, that moment stuck in my head. Like, yo, I'm complaining about going out. But I'm in the moment with Missy. Take this moment and just absorb it. Go upstairs and work.
And you didn't Snapchat that.
You didn't
Instagram it.
Yeah.
So you had to live that moment.
Oh my God, I had to live that fucking moment, bro. That was a moment, man. And that shit was like, that shit cut. But I'm like, yo, I'm still young. I still want to go out. Like, so I understand, at the time, like, I felt bad. But I was like, Missy understands. Like, I'm pretty sure she's seen this with a lot of other people. You know what I'm saying? So I just had to take that on the chin and just go downstairs and just, like,
go write a song.
Did Wiz never get caught?
Wiz never got caught.
Oh, he gonna get caught today.
Wiz never got caught. Wiz knows, so he went to the strip club with a chick, and I was like, fuck, bro, what's up? I'm in this crib by myself.
Damn.
It was lit. It's cool, though.
So when you was in Miami, you said you wasn't getting paid, nothing like that. Broke, still, you know, trying to figure stuff out. Did that ever deter you? Like, did it ever make you think, like, what the fuck am I doing?
Yeah, it did for a minute. I was about to get a real job.
Oh, shit.
A real job, and then everything just turned around, bro. Like, when you feel like you about to give up, everything turns around. And man, thankfully I got great parents who just, like, my pop still, like, was pushing me. Like, he never said come home. He never said come home, because if that was the case, I probably would
flew home 5 years ago. Like, when I got here,
you know, like, I knew I didn't want to go home. And your parents said that's kind of like them not believing. And my parents never stopped believing. So I think they kind of gave me like the notion like, you ask for this, go.
Right.
Go.
So your mom and them just sent you out here. Did you go to college or
anything? Yeah, I went to school. I think that's why the reason my parents were so cool with me,
Leaving?
Yeah, because I gave them what they wanted. I went to school because my brother was locked up. He didn't get to go to school. So I feel like that was for them.
And Memphis is like, people don't know. It's kind of rough out there.
Yeah,
You got Yo Gotti, dogs.
It's rough. Memphis is rough, and that's what's so, I promise you, like, my crew was the cool kids of Memphis.
Okay.
We started like that cool, like, man, like, niggas wasn't really sneak peek. The whole Arsoul era, like, it feels so long ago, but like, yeah, that shit was like, we really, like, nobody was dressing like us. We was weird people. People used to think we was weird.
And that was cool.
I mean, at the time, it wasn't.
But it's cool now.
It's cool now, but at the everything's time, cool. Yeah. But like, at the time, like, yo, people like questioning you, like, it was just weird. You know what I'm saying?
Yeah, because that's like the real South. I don't consider Miami part of the South.
We the Bible.
Y'all are like deep in the South, so I can understand like that conservatism.
So conservative. Yo, when I got these piercings, like my aunties thought I was probably the worst person in the world. You know what I'm saying? But like, you just, like, this is
who I am.
Always been me. I always had that in me.
Yeah.
I always had this in me. You know what I'm saying? It was just, you know.
How much of that do you put into your music? Like, because I know you write for other people, but do you put a little bit of you in there, or do you try to take the who that person is and make a song for them? Because some artists, like, they'll have a song written, or they'll look at somebody and write specifically for them, or...
It depends. Like, on my stuff, it's all me, or I take from my friends. Like, I take from my friends a lot.
Okay.
But, I observe everything. So you don't think I'm watching, but so I
and then make a song about it.
Yeah,
that's cool. Man.
So fast forward, we hear that you was like the defining factor in the Monica album. How did you meet her, and how did that relationship start?
Monica,
she fucks with you. Did she shout you out on Twitter and this past weekend? Like,
she waited for you to come. Like, she was gonna stay. Like, we saw the love. We actually saw
it. I love Mo. So I met Mo through Polo Dunn's, my manager.
Yes.
Polo Dunn's my manager and Zone 4, and like, dang, what's so crazy is he was like, yo, we about to do Monica album. Here's a beat. And baby, I did that joint just right for me. And then I did this other song that I fell in love with. Like, I did it in 15 minutes. I remember they went to go eat. And I came back. They came back. I wrote that song so fast. And then they came to the studio. She heard it. And then I think she was like, yo, like, who is this? And then she wanted me to write a song about her relationship. And I wrote deep. Like, she realized she can talk to me. And whatever she wants me to say, I'll put it in a song for her.
Wow.
So, yeah. So it was really dope, right, doing that. Because, like, it was real R&B. Like, her project was just real R&B. It wasn't no gimmicks. But I was still trying to keep it cool with Just Right For Me, with us, you know, with the swag. But like, it's real R&B. And I think, like I just kind of showed myself that I can do that. You know what I'm saying? I can do R&B because I'm an R&B chick. I'm really R&B. But, you know what I'm saying? I'm a hybrid. I can do that too. You know, so it was cool.
And y'all did that in Atlanta?
Yeah.
Oh, okay.
We did the album in Atlanta. We did like two songs at Danger Studio and Hollywood.
Oh, yeah. We shot Rico's interview in Danger Studio. Yeah.
So that's a
beautiful studio.
This is nuts.
That shit was like,
oh, this is nice.
Like, don't nothing top that. Like, that's
that
a
studio
vibe.
Is yeah. Very nice.
That's a vibe.
You worked for me too, you know what I'm saying?
Yeah, that was like,
A long time ago.
That was so long ago. That was when I first got in the game.
Were you excited?
I was around him the whole night.
Wait, you was around Beyonce?
Yeah.
Oh, my God. That's
crazy. I'm like,
I'm so shocked.
It was to the point where Jay-Z would grab my shoulder, tell me to come downstairs and hear a song. I'm like, why do you want me to
do that? Do you see him right there? That's my favorite.
Like, I can't wait to see him again. I feel like they loved me then, but I really wasn't ready for Beyonce.
Yeah.
know, I wasn't ready for her. Yes. At the time, but now I'm ready for it.
It's cool that you can acknowledge, like, you know how some people just off gate, off the top, think that they belong in a certain place. Yeah. Like, no, I wasn't ready for that.
But I wasn't ready. But she, girl, she loved, oh my gosh, every song I played, she was moving to it. Every song, Jay-Z was staring at me like, who is she? Every song.
Oh, we need to get you to Rock Nation.
No. I love Big Us Rock Nation.
No. She's like, no, I love who I'm with.
So, what artists have you worked with aside from Monica and Beyonce? I was rocking your song Sin City. That was Georgia.
That's her song. Yeah.
But who else have you worked with?
Chris Brown. I did Discover on the last Royalty album. I got his new single that's coming out. I'm so excited for this. Y'all really gonna love this joint.
I'm already excited.
I did Lil Yachty. I did Fast and Furious, the new Fast and Furious movie.
Okay.
I got a song called Mama Cito on there. That was my first movie.
Okay.
I did Fergie Milk Money.
You did that? Yeah. Oh, shit.
That shit was like huge on YouTube.
That video was everything.
Yes.
It had all the bad moms on it.
It was
and they looked good.
But it was really dope, bro. I'm excited about that.
That's why you had a lot of award shows.
Yeah.
Like ASCAP.
I was, you know, yeah, because I know I'm about to get one of them awards, so they already know, like, they prepping me.
I
hear me ready.
I see your
moves.
They're
going to give me an award song. You want to be at it. Right. If you want to be in that environment, you got to be around these motherfuckers and let them know who you are. That's what I did.
And you just walk up to people? Like, what's your approach with this whole, like, networking thing?
It depends. Like, normally, I know somebody and they introduce me to somebody.
Okay. So you need a wingman. Yeah. I'm trying to figure out the ways, because sometimes I be at this too. I'm just like,
we be like,
I'm telling you, man. I be telling artists all day, like, if you don't have it, if you're not a young nigga that know how to use the internet, like these young kids that are in high school, they got their high school friends, and if you're not that type of person, then you gotta know how to, like,
finesse.
You gotta know how to move. Like, that's why Diddy's so cool. Like, you gotta just know how to, like, get it. Go and get it. You gotta go get it on your own. And then, like, if your personality stands out and if your quality's good, if you have good quality, it's over.
They can't deny it.
You can't deny it.
Because once you put that work ethic with it, it's like, oh, I have to pay attention.
Facts.
Yeah.
Facts.
Damn. Facts. So, from Memphis, been in Miami. What cities do you prefer? Like, when you go on to work in, like...
L.A.
Okay.
I was just
LA.
In West Side.
I just got that this morning. L.A. is the best vibe to work because it's just everybody's working. Like,
boom. I think that's what it is.
Yeah,
you
yeah.
just said it. I was like, well, why L.A.? Because it's kind of the same as Miami as far as entertainment and, like, the lifestyle.
Yeah.
But everybody is on their grind. They're on their hustle. I feel like Miami is so lax that it's like, I'll get to it tomorrow. Nigga, I need this shit now. You know?
Yeah, I feel like LA is just, when you get there, you just want to hustle.
You want to work.
It's hustle season, bro. Like, it's beautiful there, but you get your weed, you smoke, you vibe, you relax, you hustle.
Right.
Like, that's the best feeling. Like, if there's two places you can't go to sleep in. If you're in New York and you sleeping at 10 a.m. in the morning, you're doing something wrong.
Right.
If you're not up at 9 a.m., 8 a.m. in New York, 7 a.m. in New York, where all this shit is happening, you're like...
Sleep.
Unless you was working crazy hard hours, but, like, it just makes you want to get up and just work, you know? Like, L.A. makes you want to work because you know somebody in those hills is working. Like, it just motivates me, but I promise you, I'm always motivated in L.A.
Mm-hmm.
When I go to L.A., I'm working, like, every week.
How do you feel about Miami?
I work in Miami, too, but Miami's home. So it's kind of like home is home. So you treat home differently than you treat. It's just, it sounds bad, but it's just like a relationship.
Oh.
In a way.
Oh, talk about these men. No. Let's go there. Come back to me, Jazzy. How do we do relationships?
I'm just talking.
We treat none at all. No. You got that pure white Henny talking.
What I mean is, no. What I mean is
no tea.
No, there's no tea to be spilled, because, like, what I'm trying to say is, you know, it's just like,
no, you, like, yeah. Even with family, like,
facts,
you know, won't treat, like, you won't tell your family certain things that you'll tell a stranger, or you won't, you'll move differently just because you know they're there.
You know, move differently. You're comfortable.
Okay, that's a good saying. I got your back.
Yeah.
Woo.
Jesus. I mean, what was that move?
I don't know. I was like, my God.
Everybody's lit right now.
Ooh, I was like, I had to figure it out. I had to sneak out of that one.
Yeah, he was like, what was wrong?
I said the wrong thing.
You should always catch something. But let's talk more about like the music scene though in Miami, because you know, we try to support it. A lot of other regions we see support their own. But do you see there's like a disconnect here at all? Or do you feel like everyone's starting to work together?
Nah, it's not a disconnect. I just went to a show where Trippy Red and Extension X, and my boy Chief Pound, dope DJ, they was all together, man. And
that was here?
Yeah, at the Anger.
Oh.
And I'm like the new generation, like 19... 18-year-olds, 17-year-olds, these, like, they supporting each other.
Mm-hmm.
Like, Trippy Red supporting XX, you know what I'm saying? Kodak Black supporting X, Denzel Curry, like, Rob, all these niggas, like, they just all supporting. I really see South Florida, like, doing
something. It's starting to.
It's about to be a wave with producers, with everything.
Who are some producers that you are like?
Man, Ronnie J.
Oh, he's out in LA though, right?
No, Ronnie J. does it.
No, I know, but he was Denzel's DJ, right?
Yeah,
he's out.
Producer.
I thought he was his DJ.
Yeah, he just got signed, so he's about to come out as an artist.
I saw him, like, he's on his little,
yeah,
his little hit trippy wave.
Jimmy Duvall, he's a dope ass fucking producer. I remember him a lot. You know what I'm saying? He's really dope. He did XXX Look at Me.
Okay.
Danny Boy Styles with XO.
We might need to get y'all to come back and do like a producer, and we, you know, talk the beats, talk behind the beats.
Nah, it's a lot of producers out here that's like killing. But these niggas is really, I don't know what's going on with the older school.
I felt like after, I'm talking about like 23, like 24 and in between, there was a disconnect. And then, like you said, 19 to 17 years old, they have technology, so they get it. Yeah. But everybody else, many groups.
I don't know. I feel like that's in general in hip hop, though. You still got the old heads talking down a little bit, not understanding the way stuff is moving.
Gotcha.
But maybe, I don't know, do you see in Miami, though, the older people that been out, do you see that there's a disconnect there?
I don't think so. Because people respect Uncle Luke.
Yeah.
I respect Uncle Luke, and I'm not even from it, but I respect his freaking, what he did, for the culture. Like, these young niggas in Florida, really, I feel like they respecting, like, the old school. And I don't know Khaled, I don't know, Ross, but I know Kool and Drake, and I know, like, some of the legends like that, and they always show love to always showing love to New York. Kent Jones. That's my brother, and I support him 120%.
He's an amazing talent. Yeah. Outside of being an artist, his musical talent.
Yeah. Can't scare.
He's one of the, like, I remember when before all this dropped, I just remember like this, and he played me some music, and I closed my eyes and I saw colors. You know, like, and
that's crazy.
That
shit was amazing. It's like colors.
You know how you look when windows used to shut off and you had to see all the designs? And that's when I know music is good. Like, I either feel something, or I do that type of shit.
You're right.
He's definitely dope.
He's amazing.
I'm excited to see what's about to happen, because Miami is definitely getting a lot of love with, like, the new artists.
Yeah.
Like, Bruno Mali's, you said XX.
Yeah.
I don't know, who else? Like, Kid Omar. Like, I see them. Like, they're getting love on, like, XXL and shit like that, so...
No, they're doing it.
They might have a weird, of course, Kodak and Denzel.
South Florida got a movement. They are definitely
just kind of. I just need everybody to like support it wholeheartedly and not just for what it look like. You know, like really fuck with it.
You don't think they support it?
I don't. I feel like people are coming together, but I just still feel like
the beach and the
because
the two different scenes though.
It's two different scenes, but. The world don't know Miami as a person. Like, I was in LA and my Uber was like, I don't know how you guys do it. And I'm like, what are you talking about? He's like, I'm like, South Beach is not Miami. And I told him about the area of Wynwood. He's like, people kept telling us to go there, but we just didn't go. People don't always make it towards Miami, so they don't understand that there's a whole culture and world outside of the beach. So you got the rest of the world not knowing and not being exposed to what Miami truly has to offer.
Right.
That's the scary part about Miami, which is why I think it doesn't go as big as it could go. Mm-hmm. You know? Just, I don't know. That's my observation.
I just feel like the DJs got to just support South Florida music more.
But what outlets do the DJs really have?
The club.
With clubs.
Well, actually, it's funny that you say that. The thing is what we're noticing on the beach is more of these club owners and the club owners are not showing loyalty to the DJs that have been rocking. So you have the hip hop DJs that we all know have been, you know, holding it down. Yeah. They're bringing outside DJs in. So it's like where you can't bring no Miami artists because they don't even know who the artists are.
Yeah, that's true.
And then too, you got certain cliques of promoters that only deal with certain DJs. And it's like, if there's a beef in any type of situation, it's like, I'm not doing that part.
And I think
much politics.
I think that's what Miami politics game is super strong. It's still strong. It's not family. It's more like, you do this for me, I do this for you, whatever. Yeah. So I think somebody has to break the barrier.
But I feel you though. DJs do need to step it up a little more.
It starts in the clubs.
Yeah. All right, well, we're going to go into this new track, this hot track of the week, and we'll be right back.
Cool. You can get anything you want. You know what I'm saying? You want that over there? You want that over there? Got you. I was up late night balling. Counting up hundreds by the thousand. I was up late night balling. Counting up hundreds by the thousand. Late night ballin', countin' up hundreds by the thousand. I was up late night ballin', countin' up hundreds by the thousand.
I was up late night balling, so far from my past misfortune. No sleeping, late nights, no eating, gun squeezing. I'm a real artesian, Ramona. I was round that counter, still down. I'm a north soldier. G slide, right down Sawyer. When we slide, you won't see morning. Another story of a young black man trying to make it up out that gym. Goddamn, back, let me make my bends. Got plans, if you hating, don't shake my hand. Take it easy, homie. Reminiscing, sitting in that Benz of the 22 bus stop way back when with the 22 five shot eyes on scan for the click clack clap or the boop bop bam cuz
I was up late night balling, counting up hundreds by the thousand. I was up late night balling, counting up hundreds by the thousand. I was up late night balling, counting up hundreds by the thousand. I was up late night balling, counting up hundreds by the thousand.
Funny, I was going crazy not too long ago. Women problems every morning like the Maury Show. Swimming upstream while I'm trying to keep my bread from the sharks. Maybe want to put the hammer to my head at the park. Probably ticking with the kids trying to get them on the straight path. Got the lanes mad, no, they hate to see me make cash. Got the space dash in the forum with the GPS address to your mama house. Conversations, what I'm all about. Took the smart route, never been marked out. Should have been dead broke, should have been chalked out. But it didn't happen, now it's time to get it cracking. Quarterbacking like I'm 40 water mix. The holy water with the Voss. Wanna be the boss, then you gotta pay the cost. Learning from the dog, I'm from Long Beach. That's a city where the skinny carry strong heat.
I was up late night balling, counting up hundreds by the thousand. I was up late night balling, counting up hundreds by the thousand. I was up late night balling, counting up hundreds by the thousand. I was up late night balling, counting up hundreds by the thousand.
All right, so talk to us about, you know, new projects, your artistry. What can you expect from you?
Man, I got so much dope shit that's on the table.
Come on, talk to us. Your little snippets. Something.
Working on a Lil Wayne's new project.
Oh, told you.
Can't wait to come to that. Cash Money got this new art group called The Years. New dope artists I've been working with.
Is it a duo? Or?
It's like four or five white boys, and they singing like they ass off.
Really? So cool. Interesting.
And they cute, and they got, I got like two songs with them, crazy. Oh gosh, there's so much shit. What else? I was about to say something, I had a brain fart. I had a super brain fart. But working a lot with Stargate, just doing some shit with Tinashe.
Oh, I'm glad you're working with her. No, she is though. But I don't know if you heard like the little comment she made about like people not understanding her because she's mixed.
Yeah,
and I don't know if they twisted her words or what, but I guess she don't it's, feel like she understood. Yeah,
because like
she came on pop though.
Yeah, well, give me all that you got.
Two on
was like an R&B pop.
Yeah,
but her first project was nigga. Her first project was like R&B, like R&B swag. Like Tinashe is a real LA girl. Like she smokes hella weed. She's cool as fuck. You know what I'm saying? But I feel like, you know, she is mixed. So she does have two sides. And I feel like for some girls in the industry, that is tough because you got your label probably telling you to appeal to this audience, but you want to probably appeal to this audience. It's tough.
Yeah.
It's tough. So, yeah, like, I don't know what she said, but nah, she has potential to be a really good artist. She just has to make music that girls can really relate to.
Yeah. How tough is that? Because girls are like funny, you know,
they're
like
so funny.
I think it's even funny for like female rappers, like, which is why we don't have, you know, because like even with Nicki and Remy, like I like them both.
Yeah.
I understand people's plights with both of them, but if we could just like just support both of them, we'll have more female artists. It's a million guy rappers.
Yeah.
It's 20 female rappers and all of them are fighting each other.
Yeah,
why is that the case? Like that shit is so annoying.
Man, it's because like you just said, there's a million guys and there's only 20 girls. Like I feel like the media will only allow a certain amount of women in, and but thankfully, thanks to like social media and having your own platform, fuck the labels, fuck whatever, you can just do it yourself. But like, you don't, I feel like you necessarily don't have to support Nicki, you don't have to support Remy, you can support both. But you gotta understand, when we first saw female rappers, they came from groups. Like, you had a Million who was with Rockefeller.
Under him.
You had Foxy who was with
Firm.
You had Lil' Kim who was with. So it was already, that was my era. See, I didn't come from an MC Lyte. Roxanne Shante era.
Yeah.
So they had a different era, but the era that we saw, it was clicked up anyway. It was already clicked up. So, you know what I'm saying? When they was beefing, Foxy and Lil' Kim didn't like each other. You know what I'm saying? But like, it was still, oh, yo, my crew supports that, but I support that. Like, so, like, we always had this. So, Remy Ma and Nicki Minaj ain't nothing new, but I feel like the old heads are coming in, making it something different because they just don't like Nicki Minaj. The only reason you don't like Nicki Minaj is because the way she's handling certain situations.
The way she moves.
You know what I'm saying? It's the way she moves, but I feel like we just all got respect for each other. Like, we've been doing this. You cool?
No, he was moving. Call her.
I had to check it out.
That.
Yeah, like, we've been like when girl artists have always been clicked up. You know what I'm saying? And I feel like just the us, we don't have to pick like that. Like, so many females come in. Nicki can't have a radio 24/7.
Man,
that's just it.
I mean, but if Nicki can't have a radio 24/7, Drake can't have it 24/7 either.
Yeah, but he doesn't. He shares it. It's being shared right now.
I mean,
I haven't heard Drake on the radio recently. What song you heard?
Cause he chilling. He about to release some more shit on y'all. Amigos got 7 songs on the radio.
Amigos is the wave right now.
They are crazy. Amigos. Like, I wonder how much they're like. Is this them again?
They are geniuses.
Bro. Ray Sherman, Migos,
yeah.
That little wave right there.
That Two Chainz is really coming back.
I love that he came back though.
Two Chainz is
it's a vibe. Yeah.
It's a vibe.
We needed a little like. Yeah. I mean, like, cause Atlanta sound is you get a lot of versatility, Atlanta, but still that amazing. Track.
Why didn't you go to Atlanta?
I be in Atlanta. I've been working in Atlanta a lot.
I know, but like, why didn't you move there from Memphis to Atlanta?
Because I didn't have nothing there.
Oh, okay.
Like, my opportunity was in Miami.
Gotcha.
You know, if my opportunity was in Atlanta, I would have definitely gone.
Okay.
But my opportunity was in Miami, so, and, like, I fell in love with Miami. Like,
with the city, or you fell in love?
You fell in love while you was in Miami?
I fell in love with Miami.
Oh, okay. All right.
So you didn't fall in love in Miami?
I fell in love in Miami, too. Oh, I got my heart broke. fell in love.
Did you write about it? It happens to all of us.
The song Discover was about the song that I did for Chris Brown was about me.
How?
When I discovered I love you, I gotta get you back.
I'm trying to figure out how, like, the Miami scene down here as far as like relationships is kind of weird because there's a lot going on.
Mm-hmm.
Was it your fault?
Mm-hmm. I mean, no, it was yes and no, because like I just feel like can nobody break you up?
Mm-hmm.
Can't nothing, like, you have to already, I have to have done so much fucked up shit for you to come to this realization, because when women love, we love hard. So it had to do with a lot of shit.
Okay.
I don't think it wasn't just me. It was her insecurities. It was me. It was distance. You know what I'm saying? It was everything. But I probably added to it, but like not cheating. It was just
not being there, probably.
It was just like I'm everywhere. And so if you're not used to a person just being, everybody fucks with them.
Right. In your eyes,
everybody fucks with them.
It's hard to be in a relationship with somebody who is, first of all, is even in the entertainment industry,
yeah.
because
yeah.
you might misinterpret a relationship they
yeah.
have with a promoter, a DJ, a fan, whoever.
Yeah.
And I go through that all the time. Like,
yeah.
sometimes I'm just like, what the fuck? Why are you always out? But that's part of the image. You know what I'm saying?
Yeah.
So I can only
like,
imagine.
You fell in love with the person that you saw. You saw
right.
me in the club.
I met you in the club.
You saw me
Nobody
in the club. Son, nigga, what's up?
But Miami does add an extra pressure, though, because, like, yeah. you can get into anything out here.
Yeah.
It's hard to find love, period. But
Miami, I think,
is one of the hardest cities to
yeah,
find.
Yeah, I feel bad for any girl in Miami.
Yeah.
Trying to find love.
Bruh.
I told that reason that I feel bad for any girl in Miami.
It's just hard because I think there's a stigma of how the females are out here. And if
yeah.
you're not that girl, you already expected to be her.
Yeah.
And then you get caught up with somebody that's used to those type of chicks. And they treat you like that,
yeah.
even though they don't want to. They probably really want to be with you and really want to do the right thing, but they just so used to the foolishness.
This city's going to always be known for, like, play. Like,
so
niggas come to Miami.
You have to say all your friends are, like, married from back home?
Most people I went to school with, like, they married. Damn, like, people that graduated before me got, like, 6 kids.
Yeah,
it's
totally
just
agree.
Different.
I'd be like, yeah. am I not growing up? Like, I'm about to be, 30.
I think it's different for everybody. Especially, like, you graduated in high school like 05, 06, 08?
No.
Oh, 08. Okay, you're younger than us.
I don't know why I knew that, but
I feel like
she's in classic.
Yeah, well, we're around that time. But
I graduated college the next year.
Yeah. But I think, like, anybody now, especially the younger generation, see that there's so much to attain that
mm-hmm.
we're not like our parents, where it was like get married at 25, have kids. White picket fence.
Yeah,
have jobs. Like,
Jill Tracy told us we got to about 40, 45.
Yeah.
Until shit hits the fan.
Like,
right.
Our parents got married at 25, 24. Like, and my friends were getting married at 25, 26, 28. I'm like, what?
Yeah.
Am I messing something here?
Bro.
I'm
like, I still can't take care of myself.
Dude,
so,
especially the kid part. How you got two kids?
I
can't even fund my habits.
I don't think I would be a bad mom, but I just can't see me being a mom right now. The way
yeah.
I move, like the other day, I was like, oh, I'm about to, I'll be back. Like,
you can't do that with a child.
Exactly.
Guys can't all day,
right?
But a girl,
like, hell no.
You gotta make sacrifices. Unless you got a good mom. That's that grandma that be like, I'll raise your kids for
or
you.
Or a nanny. Unless you financially stable.
Who can afford a nanny?
Yeah, that's
in Miami.
Right.
Like,
I feel like a nanny is just too personal with your kids to me. Like, I feel like you gonna call them mama.
And you watch SGBU, they be stealing the kids and stuff like that.
So we just got a notification. So OJ was granted his parole.
Oh, yes.
Yes.
I ain't black, I'm OJ.
Even though he ain't been black since.
What?
He his wife.
But he did state that once he gets parole, he's moving back to Florida. So he gonna be out here.
Good. Get your ass.
All of them out here. Vanilla Ice, OJ, everybody.
CNN just gave the notification.
Good. So he's getting out.
Yeah. After 9 years. He's been in there. I didn't know it was 9.
I didn't know he was in jail.
Yeah. I knew, but I didn't know.
I forgot. But still in his own shit.
Yeah. Which, yeah.
So
that shit was crazy how he kind of put that whole scheme together.
Got away with murder.
Got away with murder.
But you got caught for being a thief.
Right. But we'll see.
Real quick, how do you feel about 4-4-4?
It was really good. I think it was really good. Like, Story of OJ is like my favorite song on there.
Okay.
Just because, like, he really talked Josh Jules, and it was a great album. I feel like Jay-Z can't talk about Jules no more.
He can't.
It's perfect. He has something, like, I feel like he was inspired to talk about Black and what's going on. And his situation would be, I think it was perfect. Showed his age.
I think I listened to Joe Budden podcast and I have to agree. It was almost like he went to therapy and was like, I'm about to write an album. Like, because mm-hmm. the opening, like the kill Jay-Z, then yeah. he's talking about his marital issues. It's almost like story textbook, like Fast. Therapy session. And mm-hmm. it just turned out to be a great album.
Nah, it really was. What you think about it?
I liked it. I really like the Mercy Me song.
Marcy Me.
Yeah. I'm not like the biggest Jay-Z fan, yeah. so but I can appreciate art and I can appreciate the message that he's giving to everybody.
Yeah, and I think it killed 444. That's
444. Smile was amazing because nobody ever knew nothing about his mom. But yeah. it's so much deeper than his mom's situation. It's like everybody's walking around here living a facade and not being the person that they want to be. Imagine you're at stardom and you can't even be you because you got to be this person that everybody wants you to be.
Yeah,
and that's what a lot of artists is dealing with. That's why a lot of artists be depressed. A lot of actors be depressed because they can't be themselves.
Or addicted to something.
I think we judge people and we don't really understand why they're doing it, but it's probably their escape from the fact that they can't just be a regular person anymore.
I feel like it's getting better. I feel like in today's world, you can be whoever you want. I feel like you can, like, if a guy was to come out as a rapper and be gay, I feel like it could work right now.
It's perfect time. Everything's pretty open.
It's perfect time right now. Like, if you have any inhibitions, if you're afraid of anything, my nigga, you could be whatever you want. And you could be, if you want to be a big drug dealer, you can be that right now. In a song.
I wanted to be that one day.
Do whatever you want today, like, in a song, like back then they used to check the record, check the facts. Like,
yeah, fact sheet. Mm-hmm.
Like now it's like, yo, you can just be the lamest nigga and talk about all the bitches you fucking.
But is that really okay?
Not at all. Okay. But it's working.
So if you want to just get in there real quick and be with fuckery, you can go ahead and do it, but then bring your ass back out.
I don't agree with it. I don't think it's cool, but it's working.
I'm really from
the old school.
Like, you from Memphis. They are, it's hood. Like,
yeah, but I mean, but it's beautiful. It's like, it's a lot of soul there.
That's like Yo Gotti's album. The song you got with Keisha Cole, I forgot. It made me feel like, damn. Like,
you mean K Michelle?
I meant K Michelle. Yeah. I said Keisha Cole. Yeah, K Michelle. The song you got with her.
It's not a lookalike, but.
Right, everybody started looking like this. Shout out to K Michelle, I'm sorry. But yeah, like, it was very soulful. Yeah. You know what I'm saying? Everybody used to Yo Gotti with the, like, slide in the DM. But when you listen to him rap, you start to feel, you understand where he's from.
I remember being in middle school and, like, seeing Yo Gotti drive by and being like, yo, it's Gotti. Oh my God. Like,
he really out there doing it for the city. And
Well, people think, like, Nashville's always the bigger music city, but it's really Memphis because you said the soul, the jazz.
Yeah, there's a lot of artists, musicians. Like
Nashville's got the money. Nashville's Hollywood status.
Yes.
Country Hollywood.
Country Hollywood.
Memphis, we don't have the money, but we have the artists. Yeah. Like blues came from Memphis.
Mm-hmm.
Fucking everything came from Memphis, bro. Like, High Records, Stax Records. My mom's was High Records.
Mm-hmm.
So, like,
your mom was like a singer or something?
Yeah.
Wow. Oh, so you come from a musical background.
Yeah, mom had a Billboard song on the Billboard charts. Yeah. Like, she was with Ann Peebles, Missy Elliott, sample I Can't Stand the Rain from, like, Ann Peebles.
Oh,
wow. That's crazy.
So it was meant for you to meet.
Oh, yeah, you already knew it.
All right, well, to wrap it up, we always kind of end with, like, some free game you would put out there. Anybody trying to, like, just go after their dreams. Like, you kind of said some things, but what's something that you want people to take away from you?
Well, I mean, just pretty much just, like, you can't rely on anybody else to, like, just to put you on, like, especially being a female artist. Like, you have the power, like, I see, like, today, a lot of girls are coming out. They're not so sexy. They're just cool. So I feel like you don't have to have... You can use other methods, but use the power of the aura that you have within you to get what you want. But Pretty much what I'm saying, like, today for a female, it's the perfect time to get in as a female artist. If you have good music and you don't have to be all dolled up, you can't be dolled up. You can be big, you can be small, you can be whoever you want, just as long as you just got to put that hustle and put that grind in, and it's going to come. And, like, it really will come. And I feel like this is the perfect time for any female artist to come out, mm-hmm. big or small, whatever. Guy, tomboy, if you're good, this is the time. I feel like people love creativity right now. So, like, if you're a girl, don't be afraid, you know what I'm saying? And don't fall for the traps of these niggas trying to...
Snatch your draws. That's about to be a song. I snatch your draws.
Snatch them. All right. Well, we thank you for sliding through to our. You're the first interview in our new little studio.
So yes. Right.
Yes.
It's the pink room.
So it took me 6 hours to get up here. All right. Say that.
At least you know you safe though.
Yeah. Nah, that nigga came. That man fat.
I told you, man. I told
can't run after nobody. I don't know that.
That's why he had the pose. We got six of them.
Okay.
All right. We're not gonna put him on the bus too much.
All right. So you already know we are the Anti-Socialites.
Dropping each week.
Hey. Holla.
That was it.
Thank you.
Hey, it's your girl Jess B.
And it's your girl Vina Nung.
And you are now locked in with us, the Anti-Socialites.
So turn up the volume and just chill out.
Because each and every week,
we're coming with that real talk.
Conversations with Miami's business owners, artists, behind-the-scenes nightclub professionals.
As well as social activists, community leaders, and aspiring artists.
Real talk from two cool chicks curating Miami's cultures, arts, and lifestyle.